live feed is
live.
Is live. Well, it's live, and I don't actually know how long it takes for it to get.
It's like a 7-second delay or something.
Yeah, it has to buffer somewhere. So yeah. And so.
Some server someplace.
Yeah. So. And what I do here is I go into Facebook and go to our page and then open up the twisties.
Yeah, I can't open them though. I can't open twisties. I'm not strong enough.
And I'm putting this back here because my guitar neck will be over there.
Yeah. She'd be moving over there.
Well, I needed to put it, set it down before I dropped it, so.
You know, one thing about Facebook that has really just become egregiously annoying is
just
that
one thing?
The thing.
Okay.
Never had this problem before. And now it just takes forever. Sometimes I have to refresh pages 2, 3, 4 times to even see the content.
Which is strange, because I've not been having that problem at all.
On my PC, it's worse on my PC than it is on my phone.
Yesterday, twice when I logged in, there were like 3 posts, and that's all there was. So I just left and did something else, and came back, and all the posts were there again.
Well, and I know people who are being required to sign in every time, no matter what they've got their preferences set for. So, yeah, Facebook is losing their.
A lot of people hadn't. I don't know if it's just because it's gotten so much more use lately or because of the changing over to the new format, they've not.
I would guess that's it.
They're not paying attention to the other problems, and so they're just more glitches right now.
Yeah, oh, that was what I didn't check before I put the feed on.
Who knows? Well, it seems to be feeding, and I can't jump off of it at this point. I meant to check. Right, but it drops everybody.
So you just wait to ask your question of them, and they'll tell you.
Well, it's not that. Sarah's on, and Josh Brandt is on, and folks are joining. I don't know if I'm attached to down here or upstairs.
To which Wi-Fi?
I put Wi-Fi extenders in the house to solve some of our Wi-Fi issues, and it was still on the upstairs one. That was. But this came on right away, so I'm going to go with.
It never had any problems with this. It's up like once 2 weeks ago, was it? They start and then it dropped the signal because it was trying to hook up to the upstairs.
It was trying to connect. So I have one upstairs in the studio room because we don't get great Wi-Fi up there, despite what the tester says. So I put a little extension in, and it's got you can wire one Ethernet device. So I wired the studio PC, which streams all the media direct to the wireless. Hey, folks, sorry that we're talking about all kind of other stuff here.
Don't mind us.
Hopefully.
Talk amongst yourselves.
Hopefully now I can jump on Facebook and it'll operate at some level that is moderately usable. Hey, I got pictures this time. That's a huge improvement.
Is there an actual record of who comes and looks?
No.
No.
Okay. That's why I put this up, because what I can do is...
Only if they comment.
Right, which is the other thing. I think there's a lot of people who just are watching, but they're not in the eyeballs, so I'm not really sure how this thing really works. We've only done 30. This is like show 29.
So leave a comment. Tell us that you were here.
Yeah.
Tell me that you were here, especially if you came to see me.
Most people. Yeah. Well, we're live. At least I think we are. Could be something going on with my.
That looks like it.
There it goes. Yeah, and cool. And then I can see
the simulation is running correctly. Because, of course, none of us are real.
And that's highly possible. I can't seem to make the
picture smaller?
No, the picture's fine. I was trying to.
Oh, there's 4 comments?
No, I was... Oh, wait a minute.
Comments happening?
Aha! There's a new... Okay, cool.
Finally got it set up like he's been waiting to set it up for the last 30
They disappear, but at least I can see them. They've changed the layout. you used to be able to, so when we see you guys, what you're seeing, I see your comments in the left side of the video. Now it's in the right side of video, more like a chat on Zoom. So, cool. All right. And something that would be, I may wait to mention this again. We love it when folks tell us we really love that song. We have no idea which song you mean. I'll mention this again, but if you say, I love that song, just type the title or the first word of the title, really love that Eagles tune or something, because we don't know which songs you're saying you love, although a lot of you say you love all the songs, so it may or may not be particularly helpful. Caitlin joined us. Okay, so this week, one of my lifelong friends, we went to high school together, Rick Smith, known in the SCA as Connor McClellan, one of the folks who got me started in the world of guitar, and we performed countless bazillions of performances.
Bazillions is a good word.
In the SCA, yeah. We have the distinction with another friend, Farnan Monagar, who might join us in October, of getting one of the first award of the Groves in the Middle Kingdom. I think we're number two or three or four. We're way out there nearly going from doing a lot of playing.
And unlike most times people get group awards, it was named to you specifically.
Right, it actually mentions our names. It's the only Grove that ever done that way. You know, maybe we got to see it about two and eight. Yeah, getting. Of course, we don't have a camera wide enough for a stage of four. All right. So, anyways, he goes on. You've met Connor, Caitlin. You may not remember. It's been a while. That's Caitlin Stewart, Queen Caitlin Stewart.
Oh,
we've played for her a few times.
Yeah,
pretty sure.
We've met a few times.
Yeah. So this week I am playing. It's back to back weeks of Ovations. So I'm playing the Ovation 6 string this week, the beautiful Koa Wood Sunburst top.
I'm playing my Washburn Rover for really the first time playing it out, so I'm kind of excited about that. It's a little travel guitar.
It doesn't sound little. It's got a really nice sound.
I was thinking most people don't know about travel instruments, and so a lot of people would be going, what's he playing? It's a guitar.
Yeah, it's a Rover.
It's
the Washburn.
For traveling.
Yeah, and it's got a really nice sound. I got one on a scratch and dent off of a musician's friend, and the scratch and dent was the zipper on the case was broken. $99. And Mary put a new zipper on the case, and I've taken it a lot of places. It's a very nice. I think the thing that I think that makes the Rover nicer than a lot of the other ones is that the fretboard is full size.
Yeah,
and width, it's full width, I should
say.
Yeah,
it's a grown up guitar
along
with a little tiny body.
Yeah.
That still has good sound.
Yeah.
I'm playing my McCalla. McCalla is the brand name. Pineapple soprano ukulele. McCalla is the less expensive line put out by Kala, which is a good moderate range price ukulele company.
Is it the one I bought you?
Yes. This was my 25th wedding anniversary present for Kat. I had it on my wish list, but I did the research.
I couldn't remember if I bought it for you for Christmas. I bought it for you as an anniversary present.
Yeah.
So instrument manufacturers, if you send us instruments, we'll play them online.
We will. We're already playing most of the manufacturers. Let's see. We don't have any Martins. I wonder if Antares is still around. Do you still have your Antares guitar?
Oh, no.
Did you get rid of that thing?
I have no idea. I think it's in Texas.
After we got you the Alvarez?
The Alvarez.
Yeah,
still
yeah, yeah. Okay.
And we're drinking Cider Boys.
Oh, yes.
So sponsor us, Cider Boys.
And you are drinking the...
I'm drinking the First Press.
I'm drinking Grand Mimosa.
And I'm drinking Blackberry Wild.
So take note, Cider Boys, and send us a sponsorship.
All right. I think it's, I can't, the light is just perfect. And I can't tell what time it is.
I think it's just 7.
All right.
6:59.
All right. We've got 15 people on.
That's
okay. So.
Comment.
Yeah, please do comments. Again, artist songs. We're continuing to try and grow our library, and I think Rick's going to join us again in probably about a month. We've got folks coming on, but it should be some fun. I think this is a fun set to do, and maybe next time we'll do some some ska-esque stuff.
And while we hadn't planned it out this way, we just told him to pick songs we had on the list, and he picked out, I think, 4 out of 6 of them someone requested.
Yeah.
But only one I can remember who requested it. Or, no, two. Two I can remember who requested.
So we had a lot of requests tonight.
This
so.
One, I think, is a request.
All right. Good.
Close enough for Jack.
Good enough. Good enough for the basement stage.
And
was Free Fallin, 1987. Obviously, Tom Petty, also co-written by Jeff Lynne of ELO from the Wildflowers album, which sounded a lot like Tom Petty fronts for ELO.
Very little like Tom Petty, the Heartbreakers.
You know, he sold a gazillion million records, so I'm not one to criticize. I really like ELO, so
I really like Tom Petty. So.
So I'm gonna have a drink of cider. I really need to get rid of that. I have the date and fight practice thing that keeps coming up.
There is no fight practice. There is only Zoom.
Wow, I forgot how much I like that. Like cider and orange juice, grand mimosa.
Two great tastes that should go great together.
I have to tell you. Cider and orange juice. Okay.
You put it on the list, though.
I think this is another one. The first time I might have ever heard it was from Keith. I don't remember a lot of these songs. All right, here we go.
1972.
Yes.
I was 7.
I was 14. Depending on what time of year it came out.
You were a huge America fan. So apparently you weren't that huge of an America fan.
I tried to do the math and I think it was 14. I tried to do math in my head.
72.
Yeah. So,
yeah. I had never not heard of America at that time.
I know. At that point, I only knew that there was one station on the radio, WONE Country.
Oh.
That was all we listened to.
My mother was at WHIO, which was talk and old people music. And then there was WING, which was everything we counted as rock. Rockabilly, everything that was not...
This was the pre-TUE days?
Yes.
Yes, there was the rock station. And then the country station, which had both country
and
western. That never stopped being funny.
That's why we keep making that joke. Because it never stops being funny. Alright. This was definitely a request. I know somebody requested this. We don't know who, but somebody out there. Here we go. Don't worry about it.
Don't hit count it in.
We're following you.
I know. 1, 2, 3, 4.
My child arrived just the other day. He came into the world in the usual way, but there were planes to catch. Bills to pay. He learned to walk while I was away. If he was talking for I knew it. And as he grew, he said, I'm gonna be like you. Yeah, you know I'm gonna be like you. And the cats in the cradle and the silver spoon. Little boy blue and the man in the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when. But we'll get together then. Coming home, man, I don't know. That was, of course, Cats in the Cradle. Words of music by Harry Chapin, 1974. Probably one of the most recognizable ballad songs on planet Earth.
I think I've been playing it since I was 12. It's the only song I knew when we started this set.
That's part of the fun. I mean, at this point, though, we're kind of, short of us pulling out some songs from, like, the game night sets, we're beyond the point where we've ever even tried any of these songs. I mean, I know some of them, but, like this song. I know this song very well. It's in my constant rotation in my 80s playlist. But to say I know how to...
You've never picked up a guitar.
Not, I didn't even think it was possible until this week.
And this next one was a request for...
I think this might have been...
Correct. Let's see. Allegra.
Oh.
Yes, you're right.
So our very good friend, Nancy Treselik, Baroness Allegra, Lady of the Pelican. Just thought I had to say that. That's never going to get old. Okay. When we first started, though, we weren't 100% sure. We played this song, but...
I'm still not.
I think that your additions to it, we're just making it go. This is really fun. I'm glad we're able to do this song. So, like, one, two, three, four.
I'm coming to your life.
was Everybody Wants to Rule the World by Tears for Fears, written by Roland Orzabal, Ian Stanley, and Chris Hughes, 1985. Another one of probably the most recognizable songs on planet Earth from the last...
Something from the 80s.
Yeah, this song still gets... You hear this song all the time. Thank you for that suggestion. That was a good learning experience.
I think someone requested this.
I do think somebody requested this. I want to, before we play this song, Charles doesn't always get on, but I'd like to say thanks to my friend Charles Krug from up in Michigan. He is an extremely talented musician who was able to help us decipher why we couldn't quite get the sound for this song right. And we'll tell you about it after. But this was another requested song.
Years.
They were big with the Egyptians, I'm sure. That just has music has a timeless quality.
No, I don't know if they could beat Mambo Number 2.
That's yeah. But Lou Big, it hadn't quite got to Mambo Number 5.
That's
yeah.
Right.
Now we're to our last number, which was requested by my sister Barbara. And she said, "Oh, I probably won't."
Nothing in East Water.
It's okay, you guys can't do this. And it's like, who can do it?
Took us a few tries.
Including changing the key so we could all actually reach the notes.
Hey,
you pray, please. Speaking of reaching the notes.
Yeah, I might.
Otherwise, not so much.
Yeah, this was one that did require some clever rekeying, which probably took us. We spent 4 hours working on songs on Saturday or something like that.
So if you come late, thank you for being here. Please leave a comment and let us know your song.
Please do. And again, if you like a particular song, tell us which song you liked. We might go track down songs by those artists if we knew which ones you really liked. Okay. So again, thanks for joining us. Here's our last song of the evening.
I have a funny anecdote about this song.
Okay. One, two, three, four.
I sang this song to the inflatable love sheep and danced around and offered it a ring and flowers and then took it off into another room with a do not disturb sign on the door. And my teacher initially gave me a C. He said it wasn't very creative. And then one of my classmates pointed out to him that I was singing "When I Come Back Home to You," E-W-E. And he was like, "Oh, that's very clever," and he gave me an A. Now, the funny part is, I had no idea. That was not my point. Oh, no, I was getting credit for being much more clever than I was, but I got the A.
Better than being less clever than you actually are.
That's right.
And if you wonder what makes it an inflatable love sheep, you're welcome to go look it up on the internet or on Amazon and get your own inflatable love sheep. I believe the last I remember of it, I'm not even sure what happened to it.
Probably deflated.
Don't talk to me. I gave it back to you.
Yes, I know. And it was used as a mascot roaming around the pool tables at Stubby's on a pool stick. So that's our show for this week. We thank you as always. If you have suggestions for artists at least, and we may revisit some songs that we didn't think we could do, we may try and learn them. But give us some suggestions for artists, and we'll continue to hunt down songs.
If there were songs like in April that you really love and would love to hear again, we have no problems redoing songs as long as it's been a while so people won't get tired of them.
Yeah, I think the April and May songs, if you go back to some of those lists, I mean, we barely knew what we were doing and were significantly improved.
And it'll be easier for us if we have one or two songs each set that we actually know.
But that's not going to stop us because next week's set is no songs that we know.
Right, and you needed
to I swapped it, I already did.
Okay.
So, so we had a lot of fun, and thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
We'll plan on doing this again. Mm-hmm. And everybody, we hope that you are safe and well.
Thanks for
And we will
by.
See you next week, same time, 7 p.m., and we'll see you for another show. Thanks, everybody.
Thanks,
love
Eddie.
You.
And, oh, my cousin Tracy was on. Oh, so Jason and Nancy were on.